think lips are a very important part of the face. So many women come in and that's really what they want, is they want to augment their lips. I think there's a lot of bed work out there, and I think that to do good work, the first thing you have to do is really understand proportions. And you could go back even to classical beauty described by Da Vinci, and you have to understand that really the upper lip is not supposed to be taller than the lower lip. There's actually a proportion, kind of 1 to 1.4 or 1 even to 1.6, where the vertical dimension of the lower lip should actually be higher than the upper lip. So if you have a very large upper lip, it kind of looks duck-like or like a trout pout. So that's not an aesthetic thing. So when women come in just asking for the upper lip, you need to educate them with a mirror and point out the classic proportions. Then you have to have a second mirror and show them their profile, because a lot of people don't realize that the upper lip should protrude on lateral view just about 1 millimeter below the lower lip, but not much more than that. And then after you do that, you have to look at the whole face. It's got to match the face, what you do. And if there's any asymmetry, you attempt to correct it and point it out to the patient. When all that is finished, actually there are 6 steps that I've kind of put together that I think are just basic steps that can be used to make a very aesthetically pleasing lip. Step number 1, to look at the philtrum columns. Those are those columns from the nostril down to the Cupid's bow. And ideally, you should augment the column that the patient has, step 1. And step 2, basically enhance the Cupid's bow. And we do that in a vertical direction by injecting from the wet line up to the edge of Cupid's bow. The 3rd step is along the vermilion border medially, but we don't want to do it all the way laterally to the commissure, or you'll get that ducky look. We just want to enhance the medial portion of the lip so it looks a little diamond shape. And then the 4th step is, it's important to give some dimension to the lower lip, what I call little pillows or tubercles. You avoid the midline, but you put a little depot injection on each side of the lower lip right into the belly of the orbicularis oris muscle to give that a little volume, and you massage it so it looks natural. And then I like to bolster the corner of the commissure on each side. That would be step 5. And step 6, enhance the nasolabial fold, because that can help evert the upper lip. And I think if you follow those 6 simple steps, you can have nice looking lips with a single syringe of an HA product, whether it be Restylane, Juvederm, Biletero. There's a lot of bad work out, and unfortunately, I think that gives everybody a bad name. So please don't inject until you've really studied the steps and you've got it down. And then I think it's a beautiful reflection on our specialty.